I think my favorite thing about Genesis that I love is the fact that we have no losers here. Everyone is a winner. Our show is about heart. It's about people helping people. And if there was ever a family value that our country needs more than anything else, it's a helping hand. It's us reaching out to someone. It's us trying to help other people. And speaking of winners, my very favorite part of the show is our Genesis Helping Hand segment. Take a look. Look at those smiles. And you'd smile, too, if you were getting a brand new van and you needed one as badly as these three young ladies did. The fine folks at Advanced Mobility and Jerry Dan, Vice President of Sales of the Rikon Corporation, teamed up to donate this customized converted minivan to the worthy charity Ability First. You see, these young people and young adults have special needs, and Ability First, formerly known as the Crippled Children's Society, offers the type of care that enriches their lives. And our thanks to the Reverend Kenneth Heaton and the congregation of the First United Methodist Church of Norwalk, California, who presented the keys on behalf of Jerry Dan and a fine friend at Rikon and Advanced Mobility. You saw those three lovely young ladies that we presented the van to. Let me tell you a story that the gentleman from Ability First told me. They live in a group home, and they had no van such as the van that Genesis gave them. So when the other young people, disabled people in that group home, went to the movie or went to the mall, these three girls had to stay home. Thanks to Genesis, they don't have to. Thank you so much, America, for letting us help our neighbor.
Sponsor a child through World Vision.
If you're interested in becoming a contestant on Genesis, then come see us at www.genesisbiblegameshow.com. We'll see you online.
Welcome back to our very special Holy Land Challenge round. Now, normally, once a week on our Friday show, all of our daily winners will get the opportunity to win a magnificent and inspiring all-expense-paid 7-day tour of the Holy Land for their team. So let's meet our five finalists for today's Holy Land Challenge. Biff?
Jim, first of all, we have Marina Tidwell from Grace Lutheran Church in Culver City. Kathy Smith from the Bel Air Presbyterian. Daryl Lloyd, Church of Christ of Santa Monica. Aurora Bales, First Christian, Burbank. And from today's winning First Baptist team, Tamara Rickert.
Now, Biff, tell us about the special Holy Land tour we have for today's winner.
Our winning church team will fly on LL Airlines to beautiful Tel Aviv, where your inspiring 7-day Holy Land tour begins. You'll visit many revered biblical sites, including the Eternal City of Jerusalem, Nazareth, Cana, Jericho, the site of the Sermon on the Mount of Beatitudes, and the birthplace of Jesus and King David, the city of Bethlehem. You'll also enjoy a boat ride on the historic Sea of Galilee. It'll be the journey of a lifetime. Compliments of Jerusalem Tours. Jerusalem Tours, your best trip. Start with us.
Boy, that is just beautiful. Our Holy Land Challenge round consists of a series of Bible questions with our regular four multiple choices. Now, the first player to correctly answer three questions will win this fabulous trip for his church team. Players, the category for today's Holy Land Challenge round is Easter Glory. How fitting. Remember, the first player to get three correct answers is our winner. Captains, ready to take a trip to the Holy Land? Let's play our Holy Land Challenge. Our first question, the answers are soldier, gardener, mourner, fisherman. The question, in John's Gospel, when Mary Magdalene saw the risen Jesus, she thought he was a Marina.
Gardener.
A gardener is absolutely right. One question for you. Very good. Our second question, the answers are fire, skull, temptation, and rock. The site of Jesus' crucifixion was Golgotha, which means the place of the Marina?
Skull.
Skull. And that is absolutely right. Two answers. Everybody else, you got your hands on your buzzers? All right. Good luck to all of you. Our next question, the answers are Garden of Gethsemane, Mount of Olives, Sepulchre, House of Simon. According to the book of Mark, where was Jesus' body taken after the crucifixion? Marina, this is for the win, if you're right.
Sepulchre.
The Sepulchre. Is she right, and is her team going to the Holy Land? She is. 3 out of 3. Super. Congratulations, Marie. Boy, please win 3 in a row.
That's terrific. Kathy, thank you very much. Cheryl,
Aurora, you guys played great today. This is just wonderful. I never thought we'd have 1, 2, 3, and there you are. Your entire church team will be able to go to the Holy Land with you. We congratulate you. It's going to be great. Another big round of applause. That's great.
Genesis is also sponsored by Testaments, the tasty candy mint with a spiritual message on every pack. Hebrew National All Beef Frank, we answer to a higher authority. And Lake to the Sky, producers of America's most popular family game, Bibleopoly. And a special thanks to the Advanced Mobility Company and the Recon Corporation, providing mobility solutions for America's physically challenged.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it was an exciting and inspirational show. Be sure to join us next time when two more dedicated church or synagogue teams will use their Bible knowledge to play for some very worthy causes. And by the way, at the end of each Genesis show, we're proud to feature our wonderful and inspirational spiritual music video of the day. So stick around. We think you're going to really enjoy it. Well, folks, our time is up. But before we go, I would like to leave you with this week's Bible wisdom quote. It comes from the NIV translation, Proverbs chapter 15, verse 15. When a man is gloomy, everything seems to go wrong. But when he's cheerful, everything seems to go right. So think good thoughts. It works every time. This is Jim McCrell reminding all of our friends out there, be sure to read your Bible and attend the church or synagogue of your choice. Thank you for watching Genesis. We'll see you again next time. Bye-bye, everybody.